Hi, and welcome to the Oral Presentation Workshop hosted by the Undergraduate Research Program. My name is Delaney, and I am the Graduate Staff Assistant for the Undergraduate Research Program. I'll be guiding you through this presentation today. In this workshop, we will cover the following information: oral presentation format, what to expect on symposium day, how to give a 10-minute presentation, outlining your presentation, designing your slides, and next steps. With this talk format, there will be a maximum of 10 minutes for presenting with a 2-minute live Q&A. Slides are typically made in PowerPoint or on Google Slides. On symposium day, you can expect sessions to be organized thematically, presenters to attend the entire session, a moderator that will introduce the session presenters and handle the question and answers, and a session assistant who will also be present to assist with technology and logistics. You may be wondering, how do I give a 10-minute presentation? First, you want to figure out the main point of your talk. What do you want to leave the audience with knowing about the work you've done? Take a moment to write down what you think is the main point of your talk and pause the video. When you're ready to resume, unpause the video. When considering your main point, think about, what is your research question? Why is it important? What is the purpose of your research? That should help clarify what your main point is. Next, consider what you want to accomplish in your talk. For example, consider, what do you want your audience to remember? You're not going to be able to share everything, so you'll want to make sure that you provide a snapshot of your research. Once you solidify your main point, you'll want to ask yourself, how does each slide support your main point? If it doesn't, you can toss that slide. However, if it doesn't relate to the main point but relates to your research, you can use the hide slide option in PowerPoint and reserve that slide to the very end of your talk in case you can use it to answer a question during the live Q&A portion. Just like writing a paper, after you figure out the main idea of your talk, you want to begin to plan and organize the structure of what you will present and the timing for each slide. We suggest presenting one slide per minute. In minute one, for example, you should be thinking about, why is your research important? Why should your audience listen? In minute two and three, consider, what question are you trying to answer? What information do you need to put your research into context? In minutes four, you'll want to think about, what did you do? How did you design your study and collect your data? How did you analyze your data? In minutes five through eight, you want to think about, what are the key findings so far? Be sure to end with acknowledgments at the end of your talk. When you think about your main topic, you want to have an attention grabber. An attention grabber is something that directly relates to the main point, such as a visual, a quotation, a data point, or a thought-provoking question for the audience. You want to focus on the big picture of your research and try to keep it accessible and relatable to the audience. Take a few seconds to pause the video and think about an attention grabber for your research. It may help to watch a few TED Talks to see how these amazing speakers begin their talks. Most of them start with an attention grabber. Your introduction and background slides should answer the following questions. What questions are you trying to answer? What information do you need to put your research in context? Your research design and methods section should include answering the following questions. What did you do? How did you design your study and collect your data? How did you analyze your data? Next, you'll want to describe your key findings so far. Remember, you only need to present findings at the time you're creating the presentation, and they can be preliminary. After your results, you'll want to contextualize your project with a summary or conclusion, then suggest future research directions. Consider the following questions. What have you learned about your findings? How might your findings lead to other discoveries? What are the next steps for your research? How might your research contribute to your field or discipline? Next, we'll cover how to design the slides for your talk. When designing slides effectively, you'll want to keep it simple, use few words, use a large font, use phrases, not whole sentences, and leave open space. To format your slides, you'll want to use University of Washington templates, department templates, or create your own. PowerPoint is recommended, and to do this, you click the Design tab after you open the presentation and select Standard Size. If you're using a template, you'll simply download the template, open it, and save it to your computer. When including visuals, you should consider what you want to illustrate for your audience. Avoid overly busy or cluttered visuals. Your visuals should be illustrative, and you should continually revisit what are you trying to convey. Here is an example of a biochemical process detailed by this visual aid, describing the main point, which is indicated by the subheader, mutation of tyrosine water access to GFP. Here is another example of a slide where the main idea was to demonstrate how people, like the person in the photo, are focused and mesmerized about a painting that is believed to have a hypnotic effect on viewers in an art gallery. And finally, here is a simple illustration for the audience to connect to a project that involves understanding a machine learning approach. Tables are another good way to present your work, especially since they're convenient for representing large amounts of data. However, be sure to keep it simple. Try to include a few columns, and if you find that a table is not properly representing your work, consider using graphs as they can be a great visual aid. If using quotations from a qualitative analysis or approach, be sure to bold or underline key points of interest that you want the audience to notice. If using quotations from another source, aim to paraphrase or use your own words first. If quoting is necessary, aim for short, impactful quotations. For example, you might say, Anderson describes conditions under which, quote, authentic participation occurs, noting the importance of including, quote, relative stakeholders and creating, quote, relatively safe structured spaces for multiple voices to be heard. It's important to consider the ways that intellectual property may influence your writing and presentation. In some cases, your mentor may have specific ways they want you to disclose information about the project in your abstract and presentation. In order to protect intellectual property, there may be aspects of your project that your mentor prefers to keep confidential until the project's completed. Therefore, it's very important that you have your mentor approve your poster before you submit it. In sum, you want to open with an attention grabber. You want to remember the pace of your talk. Don't rush. Be sure all slides support your main point. Keep it simple in terms of font, the language you use, animation, visual aids. Utilize tables, graphs, and text, and they should be easy to read. And the conclusion or summary should reiterate the big picture. And have your mentors review the content. And remember, the Undergraduate Research Symposium is an opportunity to not only present your work, but learn from your peers and build a scholarly community. As one student stated, I learned as much as I taught. For next steps, you can visit My Symposium to sign up for a presentation feedback session with URP staff. You can find up-to-date information about the Undergraduate Research Symposium. And as always, if you have questions, you can email us at urp@uw.edu. Thanks for listening, and good luck with your presentations.